Well, Jimmy Pena is an exercise physiologist and best-selling author with a list of celebrity clients. He says the key to getting fit is faith. Take a look.
Whether people go on a diet to look better, feel better, or it's just doctor's orders, few recognize the spiritual aspect of healthy eating. That's according to exercise physiologist Jimmy Pena, who teaches that faith and food go hand in hand. In his new book, The Prayfit Diet, Pena shares a revolutionary diet that's based on biblical principles and cutting-edge science. This balanced approach will build your faith and help you lose weight.
All right, he's here, Jimmy Pena. Great to see you.
Thanks for having
me. Nice apron.
You
great
like that?
Fit.
Thank you.
Now, Jimmy, you say that our health is a means of praise. And I like what you said. You have a quote saying, all we need as believers is two things, to be in God's will and to have our health. What do you mean?
God's will and good health. You know, everything at Prayfit, prayfit.com, is we steep it in grace. We look at our health through the prism of grace. And that puts faith to work. And when we do so, when we see our health as a means of praise, it changes everything. So those are the things we need: God's will, good health, and that's the gist of the Prayfit Diet.
Beautiful book here, the Prayfit Diet. Jimmy, how does prayer fit into dieting?
Well, like I said, you know, we steep it every single day, quiet times, spending time with the Lord, having our devotion, and then putting our health to work, putting our faith to work, and that includes the food. And it's so interesting. Balance is so key.
And I like that about you, Jimmy, because you don't say get rid of dairy, get rid of wheat. You say balance is the key, and you recommend a diet that's called the Simple 33 Balance. What is the Simple 33 Balance?
Well, yes, balance is absolutely key. Everything about this book is balance. In fact, the science says that when you bring the macronutrients of carbs and proteins and fats in perfect proportion, so many good things happen. Enough protein for healthy muscle, enough carbs for good sustained energy, healthy fats for brain health, heart health, lungs, and our joints. It's really, really beautiful. And we don't cut out food groups. It's an inclusive, embracing kind of meal plan. So it's really beautiful.
Now, you work with a lot of celebrities, and I guess a lot of regular people too. What's it like working with the celebrities? Because they really have to look good. So do you have to be more strict with them?
You know, the whole premise of health and how I approach the writing and the books, and I've been really blessed to be on the sets of movies and helping people get ready for projects. But the idea that our health and our food, we're a machine, you know, and whether you're going in front of the camera or, you know, you're helping your neighborhoods. And our main thing now is going into churches all across the country, talking to people about eating healthily, pushing away from the table sooner rather than later, and really, really putting our bodies to use, putting our health to work in our communities.
All right, Jimmy, we've got a full day here of food on your PrayFit plan. Let's start with breakfast.
Yep. Super important. They say it's the most important, and it is.
Yeah.
When you wake up, you've had an overnight fast. Right. And on the PrayFit diet, we have so many options in terms of breakfast. Here, this one is beautiful yogurt and berries and flaxseed and walnuts. We have omelets. We've got oatmeal, you know, all sorts of wonderful breakfasts.
Biggest blueberries I've ever seen.
Right.
Look amazing. Can I have one?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, and then for lunch, the sandwich looks delicious.
Yeah. Lunch is a bridge. And, you know, this sandwich is perfect. It's got Ezekiel bread, which is a perfect complex carb.
Can you get that? You have to go to health food stores to get Ezekiel bread.
In fact, it's everywhere now.
Is it everywhere?
Health food stores, normal grocery stores, and it's a great perfect protein.
It's a nice taste too. I really like it.
Good texture, good taste, very, very healthy. And then we move on to you know, all of these meals are just like kindling on a fire, continuing to embrace that metabolism.
Well, some people might say, you know, where's my chips or where's something? Are you just saying just have the sandwich?
Just the sandwich, just, absolutely. See, it's not much food, but this is very filling and satisfying.
But it's fueling you breath, and you don't have that sluggish feeling afterwards because you've eaten too much.
No sluggish feeling. Yeah. The healthy carbs that we have, they really help you feel full, give you that sustained energy so you don't have the lulls in how you feel.
And then I love the snack.
The snack, some hummus, wonderful fiber, the carrots, wonderful vitamins. And then The dinner is one of my favorites. I chose the chicken Jerusalem for Mom. Mom makes a beautiful chicken Jerusalem. This one, we're gonna, basically, chicken Jerusalem is a wonderful dish where we've got artichokes. In fact, artichokes are in season right now.
So we've got our chicken.
Yeah, it's kind of sizzling.
In olive oil, sizzling here in olive oil. So you're gonna teach us how to make chicken Jerusalem, Jimmy. What do you need next?
Okay.
We've got our chicken sizzling.
Yeah, okay, so once you've got your chicken seasoned, you know, in some olive oil, some salt and pepper, you can go ahead and start adding in. Why don't you hand me the artichokes?
Okay.
We'll start with some of the main things.
I love artichokes.
Okay. Yeah, throw those in there.
Those are nice, and they're so healthy for you.
And then why don't we throw this stock, and this is some chicken stock.
Yeah, it looks a little dry. We need a little, ooh, that looks
good.
Get this
going. Yes, let's turn this up a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah, so, and then we can add some leeks, and you can play around with this. Sometimes shallots will work. Mm-hmm. Put some garlic in here. I love
garlic. Oh, know, garlic would be great,
some
too.
Some spinach, too.
Mm-hmm.
Put some mushrooms,
Put
some mushrooms.
Okay.
And then once this keeps going about, you know, once the chicken is made and it's sauteing really good, then we can add in some of this Greek yogurt here. Now, in a lot of recipes, you'll see heavy cream, but we don't want to use the heavy cream. This, the Greek yogurt makes it really nice and tasty.
A little salt and pepper.
Salt and pepper.
All of it? Let's do it.
Throw it in there.
Okay, yeah. Oh, that's not that much. Yep. And you need a little salt.
A little salt.
Okay.
A little salt, and that's fine. Mix this together about 8 to 12 minutes. We're just making this nice and good, and this gets really, it gets really beautiful. And it doesn't necessarily have to be pretty, but it's delicious.
It's not super colorful, but it smells great. Okay,
no.
Then, okay.
At the end, we can add some.
This is after it's pretty much done, and you just want to garnish it with the tarragon.
Tarragon, yeah. Mm. The tarragon's going to draw a lot of good flavor out of all of the vegetables. Whatever vegetables you add to this, it's just going to kind of draw it, and the chicken as well.
What's your nationality,
It's really
Jimmy?
Good. I'm Mexican-American.
Okay, but this dish would be considered Jerusalem chicken.
That's right. It's not too far away. It's so delicious. It's one of my favorites. In fact, we've had a beautiful end product
when it's
all said and done.
Okay.
And
now that is pretty. Now we've got our tarragon and we've got our Parmesan, and so this would be a typical day
and dinner on the Prayfit plan, which there are so many combinations and wonderful recipes. It's just truly, it's delectable.
Oh, wow. I can't.
We're going to dig into this later.
It's got a little spice, not spice, but there's some, maybe it's the artichokes, because very interesting flavor.
Again, mm-hmm. it all gets drawn out, and then you can have a side salad if you'd like, or you can just have it alone. And at the end of the day, you have eaten perfect caloric proportions, protein, fats, and carbs, and research shows that when all of these are in perfect proportion, the body does some wonderful things, reduces inflammation, increases heart health, the brain works better, cognitive function. People learn better when our foods are in balance. No exclusions, embrace the food.
Because for you, all of this is a spiritual experience. And when you train people, it's spiritual.
Well, listen, food should not rule our lives, you know? It should fuel our lives.
That's such a great line. Say that again.
Yeah. Food should not rule our lives. It should fuel our lives. Truly. This is tool. Our bodies are just vessels. It's all about grace. We're steeped in grace. Mm. And that's the way we should view food.
Grace comes in when we have dessert. Okay. Jimmy's book is called The Prayfit Diet, and it's available wherever books are sold. Jimmy, it's such a pleasure to meet you. God bless you.
Thank you so much.